T-minus 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, engine start, 1. And liftoff of Delta 2 and NOAA's Joint Polar Satellite System 1, making the U.S. a more weather-ready nation.
The Delta 2 is proceeding on a flight azimuth of 196 degrees, just to the west of 180 degrees south.
Looking good. Also seeing a good symmetric burn across all six ground-mount solids.
We're listening to the voice of Patrick Moore, ULA flight commentator. 33 seconds into flight, the Delta 2 rocket will reach Mach 1, breaking the speed of sound.
Now passing 30 seconds. Chamber pressure on main engine and veneer engines continue to look good. Now passing Mach 1, Delta 2 is now supersonic.
At 49 seconds, Delta 2 encounters
a very symmetric burn across all six
maximum aerodynamic pressure, or Max-Q. This is the point where the mechanical stress in the rocket
now
reaches its peak.
Now passing 48 seconds, Max-Q, maximum dynamic pressure.
The six ground-lit solid and rocket motors will burn out about 64 seconds into flight.
Tail off.
The three air-lit motors will ignite a second and a half later.
And we have burnout and ignition of the three air-lit solids.
Approaching the jettison of the Delta 2 graphite epoxy solid rocket motors in three sequences of three. The first three will fall away 1 minute 26 seconds into flight, followed a second later by the next three.
Now 1 minute 25 seconds into flight. And we have good jettison of all six ground-lit solids.
The final three air-lit motors will continue to burn until they are jettisoned 2 minutes 11 seconds into flight.
1 minute 40 seconds into flight. Chamber pressure on the main engine, both veneer engines continuing to remain very stable. Gas generator fuel and LOX injector pressure is also looking very good.
And we're standing by for the jettison of the final three solid rocket motors.
Chamber pressure is on the air-lit solids tailing off in preparation for burnout. And we have burnout of the air-lit solids. And good jettison of all three air-lit solids.